millions of people descended on National Mall on October 16th. Young and old, white, black, and brown, they came to show respect to one of the greatest kings around.
Before DC Scores, Kenijah was extremely meek.
He was a very sort of shy but very precocious third grade student.
He quite didn't know how to find himself. He was having an identity crisis. So I would get him into different things like football and basketball, and that seems to have helped. But like when he got into DC Scores, it was like, bam, wow, this is what it is. This is it. This is what I love.
We were actually preparing for our poetry slam, and Kenijah really wanted to take a lead in our performance. He actually wanted to do one of the individual poems.
He performed a piece entitled Stand Up for the King, and it was in honor of Dr. Martin Luther King.
And it really caught me off guard because I hadn't seen, you know, that side of Kenijah during our sessions.
And I felt moved by it. It was a very emotional moment for me. In fact, I cried because here you had an eight-year-old who didn't know anything. We're not here in those eras of Martin Luther King, but he told that story as if he walked with him himself.
I have a dream, free at last, free at last. Help thou nation declare what was right and fair. He taught us to boycott and to march for what was right and to move to the front of the bus, to stop all of this fight.
I really felt like he embodied Dr. King that evening.
Here's this nine-year-old who, a year ago, you couldn't get to say hi. Now he could tell you the whole dictionary. So it was just like, I'm so grateful to DC Scores.
Thank you, Dr. Martin Luther King, for letting our freedom ring.